guys, so it's Jared, and I'm Will here. You know, we were just sitting here, sipping our wine, and we're talking about success. We're talking about, like, how can we go to the next level? You know, I know a lot of you guys are thinking about how I can become successful, and here we are talking about how we can actually go to the next level. So I thought I'd cut you in on the talk, because Jared, you know, gave some great gold and words of wisdom here, so I thought, you know, it's going to be beneficial for everybody listening. So Jared, you know, tell me this, like, all right, you're successful, right? I see your house, I see the planes, it's amazing. But like, how does somebody who can't even fathom like that level of success yet, you know, they're just trying to buy their next car, make the house payment, and they're too worried about making the house payments that they can't even think about the next level.
Yeah.
Well, what can they do, like, so that they're not always worried about making that next paycheck?
Well, I mean, in that immediate moment, it's really hard. But I think one of the things that helps people be successful in life and get over certain plateaus is understanding that life is about challenge. It is about overcoming obstacles. And I think for me, the number one thing, and I learned this maybe a little bit later in my 20s, okay, was to never be a victim. See, bad things are going to happen to you in life. I mean, whether it's just your kid's knocking over something and breaking it, or whether a bad day at work, or somebody lied to you, or stole from you, or whatever it might be. Bad things in life happen. That's just life. But see, the problem with people that aren't as successful, okay, and from my experience in life, being around a lot of successful people, the one thing they never do is play the victim, okay? They always, always, always accept responsibility, because in some way, shape, or form, sometimes it's very direct, sometimes it's just a roundabout way, but it's always your fault. Does that make sense? Because even if somebody lies to you or steals from you, you still hired that person, right? You somehow connected yourself with that person. Okay, so the first thing in terms of getting over obstacles or being successful in life is, number one, just accept responsibility for where you're at. And people don't want to hear this, okay? And unless you're a 10-year-old kid and you really don't have a choice, you are where you're supposed to be, okay? Because of the work that you put in or the work that you didn't put in.
So it's basically like taking ownership of your own choices.
Yes.
You're the one who made the choice,
yes.
Didn't you?
Yes.
And a lot of people on Instagram, I say, oh, this guy did this guy did that, I got scammed. I'm like, didn't you make the choice? Mm-hmm. Take ownership of your choices.
Well, and that's a good point. And again, guys, to be clear, it's not that bad things don't happen to good people.
Right.
It's not that just because you made a mistake doesn't mean you're a bad person, right? It just simply means you have to accept the responsibility for the mistake, figure out how you could not make that mistake again, and then push forward.
Right.
Guys, success is simply about persistence. If you will, you're going to endure obstacles for the rest of your life. That's just life. Look, some people think, guys, and I don't know, you give me your opinion in a second here, is just because you have money means you don't have problems. You know, I can't remember the rap star, the hip-hop guy, more money, more problems. And sometimes in life, that's the truth. Like, people joke about this and they joke about that, but just because you have money doesn't mean Bill Gates or Jeff Bezos doesn't have any problems. I bet you Jeff Bezos is putting out fires all day, every day. Okay, so he accepts the responsibility for it, and he moves forward. And so a lot of you guys think, well, oh, Corey, you know, that's commonsensical advice. But that's what being successful is. It's
right.
Doing the little things well, and they become really big.
So those are almost like common sense, if not common practice, right? Everybody knows what to do, but actually doing that is a totally different scenario. Just like, you know, one of the chapters in my book is like integrity, which is doing what you said you were going to do, and then doing it when you said you were going to do it. As long as you do that, man, like, it's all great. Because, you know, sometimes even, this is totally not even about success, but let's say you call somebody, they're like, oh, I'm just in the middle of something, let me call you back in 5 minutes. And you never hear from them.
You never hear, bro.
No text,
nothing.
For 2 days.
Yeah. Yep.
That's integrity, you know?
That is
how
integrity.
How you do something is how you do everything. Like, if you don't make a bed in the morning, I bet your office is cluttered.
No, it's the truth. I mean, look, common sense is uncommon. We've all seen that on t-shirts here or there. And treat other people how you want to be treated. All those things are true in life, guys, okay? So the next time, you know, somebody cuts you off and you get pissed off at them and they get pissed off, just remember, almost definitely, you did that to somebody at some point in your life too, okay? You were probably in a rush to get somewhere and you cut them off, you didn't think twice about it. But when it happens to you, oh my gosh, the world is ending on Mall. My gosh, I can't believe that happened to me. Yeah. But when you're doing it to other people, you don't think about it. So again, it comes back to self-responsibility, accepting your actions for what they really are.
Right. It's almost like, you know, when I was having dinner with one of my family friends, and they're pretty wealthy there, you know, they're borderline crossing the Billy Club, you know. And what they told me is that it's about when you do something well once, that's not enough. You gotta do it every time.
Yeah.
You can do something really good once, but that's not what's gonna give you the success. It's consistency, isn't it?
Like, it is.
Can you do it every single day? Can you bring that level of focus, that level of dedication, that level of hustle every single time to everything that you do?
Yeah.
Not just one thing. You could be good at work, but your family life could be shit. Like, being that integrity in every area. So, you know, tell me this, Jared. Like, you know, I'm single.
That's private jet up there.
So, like, I'm single. You know, you're married. You have family and everything. You know, I'm pretty sure you're, like, focused on giving them the best and winning the best of you as a father, too. Not just being a good business owner.
No, for sure. I mean, I think that comes back to a bigger question of all about success in general. A lot of people watch TV, or they watch the Kardashians, or they watch whatever, and they go, I want that, okay? And they go, I want that Bentley, or I want that penthouse, or whatever it might be.
Yeah, it's I just, want it too, but yeah, where's the plan?
Okay, but that's it. So the question is, I know what, I just don't know how. So everybody has, you know, they know what they want, but they don't have a process goal to get there. Does that make sense? So they have an outcome goal, I want a Bentley. What's your process goal? How are you going to get from A, and how are you going to get to B? And, you know, and I'm going to go back just a quick second. You know, a reminder, you were talking about somebody you knew. I was just, about 2 weeks ago now. I had a meeting with this gentleman, very, very successful. He is a big time in construction, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars net worth, big time, okay? In his office, purposely in oak, purposely, it's engraved, persistence overcomes resistance. And it's at the entrance of his office on the inside.
Right.
So he said, every time I look at the door when somebody walks in, every time I leave my office, it says, persistence overcomes resistance. Now, to the rest of the world, that's cheesy.
Right.
But when you see his lifestyle and see what he has, it's not cheesy. Because that's just life. I mean, that's how life is. And, you know, we go back to, you know, taking self-responsibility. There's no question you're going to have problems in life. It's never just perfect. So if you want to be successful, you have to be persistent. But on top of persistence, you have to have a really good reason why you're doing it. Guys, listen to me for a second. Money is not enough. Money only gets you so far as a motivator. You have to have a bigger motivator. Maybe freedom. Maybe time. Maybe you want to take your kids on a vacation somewhere. Those things are important, okay? But money itself, it's just a means to other things. So if you don't love what you do, if you really just go to work because your boss says you have to show up, good luck in life.
Yeah.
So find something you really like to do. And I know not everybody agrees with that concept. Find something you like to do. But I'll tell you, if you like what you do, Uncle, it's a lot easier to wake up in the morning and do it. You don't even look at it as work, per se.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, it's, you know, something that I talked about in the training psychology class that we did for charity, where we raised 35,000 meals. You know, that was awesome. So in that class, you know, I said, hey, find your why, and, you know, ask yourself the question seven times. Seven times ask yourself why. So, you want the money? Okay, why? Well, because, you know, to support my family. Why? Well, because I want freedom. Why? Well, because I was bullied in school, I never got it, right? Ask yourself seven times why until you get to the why that makes you cry. And that's when you know where you found the truth.
Yeah.
You know?
See, guys, look. A lot of people can talk about success. Even us, we can talk about success. I mean, I'm living success. But you have to get out there. I can't remember who said it. It was Warren Buffett. I think it's the reason most people aren't successful and they miss success because it's disguised in overalls as hard work.
Yeah.
Success is hard work. Everybody wants to talk about it.
Yeah, and the funny part is, doesn't it get harder, though?
It does. It can be hard. Yeah. I mean, I guess what I'm getting at, though, guys, is that you look at people that are successful and go, you're so lucky, you're so lucky. But you didn't see that person, that man, that woman, working 90, 100 hours a week.
Right.
You didn't see all the pitfalls they went through. You just saw the outcome that they had. You didn't see the process they had. So I want you guys all out there, the people listening and watching this, I want you to think twice, think three times, the next time you see a really successful person and you fight the urge to go, she's so lucky,
yeah.
He's so lucky. Why don't you stop before you say that and ask that person, what's your story? How'd you get there?
Right.
Okay? And I'll save that for a later date. I talked to a billionaire about 2 years ago on Mall. Changed my life. And it was all about luck. Okay? And I'll get to that the next time that you and I talk. But next time, guys, I want you guys to think. Next time you look at somebody who's driving a Ferrari, next time you look at somebody who's in a private jet, next time you look at somebody who's got that Armani Brioni suit, go, he's so, don't say lucky.
Yeah.
Okay? Think, stop, ask, how did they get there? Were they lucky or did they just work really hard over a long period of time?
It was an overnight success. It was 20 years in the making.
That's it.
People see, oh, this guy suddenly became a YouTube star. Her music has suddenly just popped up. Well, they don't see the time she was singing at the train station.
Yeah,
right? They don't see the time she was struggling to, you know, fucking just collect some money and sing, you know, in train stations and here and there, take the small gigs at bar. They just see that one video that got really views on. Yeah. She's so lucky. But no, dude, 20 years in the making, overnight success.
Guys, look, there are people that have overnight success. I mean, people win the lottery. It does happen. I saw some kid on YouTube, he gets like 100 million views, and in 18 months, he went from nothing to like $18 million a year. It happens. Mark Zuckerberg, 5 years. Guys, you know how rare that is, okay? It's, you take the one percenters, that's like 1% of the 1%. Maybe even 1% of that. So don't look at that as normal. The guy who started Snapchat, that stuff is not common, it's not normal. Most people in this world that are successful, 99% of them, even if you read that book, The Millionaire Next Door, they're average people that put in extraordinary hours, they save their money, they stay out of debt, they make smart financial decisions with hard work, good discipline. That's what success is all about, on top of taking self-responsibility and never claiming to be the victim. How do you feel about that?
You know, you have to take responsibility, there's no question about it, you know. And it's also not like what happens to you, it's like how you respond to what happens to you. Things are always going to happen. And the more successful you become, the bigger your problems are going to get.
Yep.
You know, it's just that how are you going to handle it, and are you able to bring the same level of motivation throughout? Like, you can be motivated when you start something new, right? When you start a new career, like I started trading, I was motivated. But can you maintain that level of motivation when shit doesn't go your way?
Yeah, I agree. I mean, I hope you guys enjoyed this talk. I'll be honest, it's getting a little dark outside. I think it's time to go up to the movie theater.
Yeah, that's awesome.
I'll watch a movie. So we'll hit you guys up next time. I hope you enjoyed this. Check out our YouTube channel. Have a good one, guys. Take care. Cheers.
Cheers.